Welcome to One Chemistry. Always try to do your best. Now, let us see about 100 conversion in organic chemistry. We are seeing it as episodes. This is the episode number 84. If you didn't watch previous episodes, I encourage you to go and see. Here, we solve 5 problems step by step. Stay tuned. Let us see the question number 1. The starting metal is linear chain system with 3 different functional groups, which is alkane, isopropyl group, and acid and ester. You are using B2H6 in acidic condition. They ask you to find the product. The products can be cyclized one. The way of cyclization is important. And the fate of one COO is the real question. The reactant has 2 carbonyl, product has only 1 carbonyl. So, from the reactant to product, you might understand ring closure, there is a possibility. And the reagent selectivity and the functional group selectivity is important here. The answer is B. Let us see how. The starting metal you have acid and ester, you are using the BH3. BH3 is the reducing agent which is selected to COOH, it will not reduce the ester's carbonyl. So, COOH is reduced, you have alcohol. You are having alcohol, you are having ester in the other side. So, there may be a possibility of condensation. So, we rewrite the structure for the ring closure, we rewrite it. So, OOH and COCH3 in the nearby position, which is 1,6 position. So, definitely cyclization favors the addition there. So new OH attack will be there, OCH3 eliminates and you have the alcohol as a side product and you have cation there. The cation will be quenched as the ketone. So H leaves, ketone is formed. Here you have to know that stereochemistry don't play any role, just it is given for confusion. The answer is clearly B there. Here you have to learn 2 important things. One is BH3. BH3 is a selective reducing agent, only reduce COOH, not ester COOCH3. Second thing is you have to think of possibility if you have many functional group. Here you have functional group of alcohol and COOCH3. So OH attack carbonyl ring closure is occurred there. Then the question number 2. The starting metal is alkene with ester R group. The R can be hydrogen or R can be the COOET. There are the possibilities. So the reactants only differ in the R position. R is hydrogen or COET, how it influences the reaction. The products are given, products are mostly the epoxides. Epoxide above the plane or below the plane with respect to the product formed at the first position, whether it is alcohol or ester. So mostly both are seen, both are trans or both can be seen trans is the question here. So you have to understand that the R group versus epoxide is the real question. The answer is B. Let us see how. Here you have starting metal, both are similar, only differ in the R position. So let us consider R is same. So we rewrite to the chair form, which is a twisted form because it contains the alkene there. So what really happens if R is a bulky group or smaller group? If R is the bulky group, the B attack will happen because steerically R group influence. So B attack happens, so epoxide will be below the plane. Here you are using the peracid. Peracid is the oxidizing agent. So if peracid attacked on the B position, mean you have epoxide below the ring. Second, if it is R is small, the A attack is possible. Epoxide can be on above the ring. So front side attack is possible if R is such. If bulky group dominates, you have the backside epoxide. So the answer is clearly B. Here you have to learn only one important thing. Even though the reagents and the reactants are similar, only differ in the stereochemistry. Only differ in the space, meaning bulkiness. The steric effect of the bulky group given the selectivity to the product. So if it is bulky, you got below the plane. If it is non-bulky, the epoxide above the plane. Then the question number 3. The starting metal you have long chain alkyl system. You have alkene and one methyl group is above and one alcohol is on terminal position. You are using the PCC and you are using the zinc bromide. They ask you to find the product there. The product is definitely the ring closure is occurred because you have new 6-member ring is formed. While the ring closure, what happened to the methyl, alcohol and isopropanol group is important. either all can be above the plane or below the plane are seen anti to each other. Here you have to understand that one naming reaction is involved. And definitely ring closure is occur. The answer is C. Let us see how. The starting metal, you have long chain alcohol. You are using PCC. PCC is a mild oxidizing agent. It will only convert alcohol into CO, carbonyl. It will not disturb the alkene. So alcohol convert to carbonyl there, not to acid. Here you have the alkene, definitely you might think of the possibility of rearrangement. So we redraw the structure to bring the double bond together. We redraw the 6-member kind of cyclic system. So we redraw it. Still, the product is very specific on stereochemistry. We redraw again to the chair form. There is a 2-chair form there. So we redraw it with maintain of its own stereochemistry. So we redraw the geometry. So 6-member cyclic states are possible. It's a kind of decline kind of intermediate there. So both chair forms are there. If you imagine perfectly, you have the yin reaction because it is possible because 6-member transition state, zinc bromide activate the carbonyl and trigger the yin reaction there. So hydrogen exchange occur, you have new alkene and alcohol formation. So if you redraw perfectly, the isopropanol group is above the plane, alcohol is below the plane and methyl didn't participate in the reaction, it is also below the plane. So OH methyl below and isopropanol above. Here you have to learn two important things. One is PCC. PCC is a mild oxidizing agent, is very selective to alcohol, not to double bond. It will convert OH into CO. Second thing is yin reaction. Yin reaction is a 6-member transition state reaction. If you want more specific stereo position, you have to redraw in the bicyclic chair form. Then the question number 4. The starting metal is pyridinium oxide and you have methyl at 2nd position. You are using the acetyl acetonate. They ask you to find the product. The question is whether the substitution in the 3rd position or 4th position are directly in the methyl group. So basically the CH3CO selectivity is there. From the reactant to product, you might guess the CH3CO selectivity is there and new CC bond is definitely occurred there. The answer is C. Let us see how. The starting metal, you have pyridinium oxide, which is the positive and negative charge stabilized one, which is a kind of ionic species. You are attacking with the carbonyl there. So you are attacking carbonyl, CH3CO minus leaves there. So you have new CH3CO attached to the ring. So CH3CO is there. You are rotating the bond perfectly for the next step. The next step, you are rotating oxygen carbon bond. So carbonyl coming near to the hydrogen there. Here the hydrogen, we write it like ketoenol tautomerism. So hydrogen is on the position. So nitrogen positive charge also quenched there. Here you have alkene, carbonyl and NO bond have the perfect for 3-3 sigma tropic rearrangement. Here pure driving force is aromaticity because we are recreating the pyridine there. What really happens is NO break, you have getting the CH3CO group in the side chain. It's a kind of ester kind of architecture. It's a kind of ester there. The answer is clearly C. Here you have to learn two important things. One is where is the reaction center here. There is a many reaction center. But the charge is very reactive. So reaction center is oxygen here in the first step. Second step, whenever you are thinking about double bond, you think of 3-3 sigma tropic rearrangement. So bring the bonds together and create the rearrangement there. Then the question number 5. The starting metal having dicarbonyl with active methylene group and you have ester at the terminal. You are using the formaldehyde and base and ethyl alcohol and you are heating. They ask you to find the product. The product is mostly 6-member cyclic ring which differ in the alkene position. The alkene is in the 2nd position, 3rd position or it will be on the 4th position. So the position of alkene is a real question. So from the reactant to product, you might guess cyclization definitely involved and position of double bond is a real question there. The answer is D. Let us see how. The starting metal, you have active methylene group, you are using the base and aldehyde. So what really happens is CH2OH attachment will be there. So CH2OH attached there and you have alcohol at the position. So new CC bond formation. Next step, you are heating. So water elimination occur, you have alkene formation. Here conjugation drives the alkene formation there. So conjugation form and next step proton abstraction will be there because you have to proceed to the next step. Next thing, you are having the proton abstraction. So what really happened is again new C-C bond, because there is an active methylene group, it is on the single part, so reaction continues and there is a saturation in the active methylene group. So new group is attached, which is another starting material. So you have the hydrogen and carbonyl there. So again you are using base, proton abstraction, you have the anion there. So you have many functional group, you might think of the cyclization. So ring closure occur by anion attacks the carbonyl, you have ring closure there. So O minus group is there, there is a charge travel. So the O minus group is formed. So O minus is formed after the attack of the carbon there. So O minus has to be quenched, it attacks the carbonyl in the ester form. Because ester has good leaving group, that's why it's happened there. So it attacks, it's a kind of trans esterification. Mechanism is not specified, but it is possible. So if you heat CO2 eliminates, you got the desired product. Here strain promote the CO2 elimination. This is the multiple step. So what drives the reaction? You are just creating charge and quenching the charge. Whole reaction is proceed to the cyclization and CO2 removal. So the answer is clearly D here. Here you have to learn two important things. One is you have to be master of identifying the reaction center. Here many functional group, many reaction center. Always you think of active groups. Here active methylene hydrogen. Second thing is if you have many functional group, you think of the cyclization. Simple thing, many functional group lead to the cyclized product. That's all from this episode. I hope it was easy. Thanks for watching. If you have any suggestion, comment below. Stay tuned for next episode.